ActionScript is Flash's programming language. It allows you to increase the functionality and the interactivity of your project. In this video, we're going to cover ActionScript 2.0. It's an earlier version of the language, and it's not as robust as ActionScript 3.0, but it does tend to be easier for people just starting out in Flash. So before we start looking at our project and where we need to add our ActionScript, let's make sure you have the Actions panel open. Go to the window menu and choose Actions. If you have a check mark, that means you have it open, which I do. And I always put mine on the left-hand side. It depends on your screen size or what you're comfortable with, so feel free to have a floating window or put it at the top, whatever you want to do. And you should see this little column on the left-hand side. That's if you want to create more complex actions, and we don't need to do that, so I'll collapse it. And then I have this special area up here for Script Assist. That means I have Script Assist on. So you can click this little wand button to show or hide Script Assist. If you've hidden it, then you can type ActionScript directly. And if you turn it on, then you can't type it in directly. You need to go to these menus and choose the actions you want. So before we can actually start adding ActionScript, we need to do a couple of things. We need to watch this movie and decide what we want to have happen in this movie and how that determines where we're going to add our ActionScript. So let's go ahead and watch this movie and see how it's going to play out without any ActionScript whatsoever. Okay. So as we watched that, it did something that Flash typically does. If you don't have any ActionScript, it's going to play through all of the frames that you've added content to and automatically loop it back to the first frame and keep playing. And it'll keep looping it indefinitely unless you do some kind of script to control it. So when we watched that video, we barely saw the start button for a split second, and it didn't stop and give us the option to choose when we wanted to have that start. And that's kind of annoying because if I start that movie, or if I first open that movie, I might not want that animation to start right away. I want to choose. So we need to add ActionScript so that it stops at this point and lets users click the start button when they need it. In addition, at the very end of our animation, we have a replay button, and we want to do the same thing. We want to stop it here. And people can have the option to replay that if they want to. So let's go back to frame one. And before we add actions, I wanted to show you that I have an actions layer. And you should always have an actions layer and lock it so that you don't add any artwork or content. It should always be this white layer with these empty frames and then blank keyframes. So make sure that you lock it. And as with every new layer, you're going to have a blank keyframe on frame one. When I click that blank keyframe on frame one, we can see in the actions panel a little tab in the lower left-hand corner that says we're on a keyframe on the layer with the name of actions, frame one. So if I were to unlock the music layer and click on the second frame of that layer, you can see again we're on a keyframe on the music layer, frame two. So it's important that you get used to looking at that to make sure you're adding your ActionScript where you want it to go. I want my movie to stop on the first frame and wait for somebody to click the start button, and then it needs to play. So I'll click on the blank keyframe of frame one, and in my actions panel, go to global functions, timeline control, and stop. And there's the script to stop the movie at that point. Let's test this out. And now it's just going to sit there and wait for the user to do something. That's exactly what I wanted to have happen. In addition, even when they do play it, it's going to automatically loop when it hits the very last frame back to frame one. And I want it to actually stop here so they can choose whether they not want to replay it or not. Now, when I click on the last frame of the actions layer, it looks like we already have a stop action. But if you look down here in the bottom left-hand corner, you can see it's still showing you, even though you've clicked on the last frame, the 200th frame of the actions layer, it still says that we're on actions in the first frame. That's because ActionScript can only be added to a keyframe or a blank keyframe. So because this doesn't have a blank keyframe on it, I can't do anything about it. It's going to add it all the way to the beginning. So I need to add a blank keyframe here so it says a new ActionScript at this point. So I'll go to Insert, Timeline, and choose Blank Keyframe. So now for that blank keyframe, I want to stop it here. So you're kind of thinking, why did I have to do that? It was stopped on frame 1 and it already showed it in frame 200 of the actions layer. Well, again, it only stopped on frame 1. So eventually, we're going to press a button to have it jump to frame 2 and play all the way out here. So we need it to stop again on frame 200. So let's go back, and now we need to add ActionScript to the buttons themselves. So this is a hard thing sometimes for people to grasp with 2.0, is where they should add their ActionScript. And you have to think about what you're trying to control so that you know where to put it. I'm trying to control the timeline and when it plays and when it doesn't, so I added ActionScript to the timeline itself. And as you can see, it has a little A on the first frame, and that's telling you there's ActionScript there. You should only see those little A's on your actions layer. And I have two blank keyframes so that it stops on frame 100 and it stops on frame 200. I'm trying now to control the start button, or I want to try to control the start button. So I need to click on that button itself. Let's go ahead and unlock the buttons. I need to click on the button itself and add the ActionScript to that button. So when I've selected the button symbol, in the bottom left-hand corner, you can see the icon for a button symbol and the name I gave it of BTN Start. That's the name I gave the actual symbol itself in the library. So it's saying I'm going to add actions to the symbol button start. Again, we'll go to the plus sign, global functions, timeline control, and we want it to go to a certain frame and play. Now, if for some reason you can't, these are grayed out and you can't click on them, I don't know why it happens, but when that does happen, save your project, quit Flash, open it again, and it'll have all these options available for you again. So I'll go ahead and click Go To, and I have a couple of options here. I can choose it to go to and play, so it can go to frame 2, which is when my animation starts, and play it, or I can have it to go to and stop, where I want it to go to frame two and it's just going to sit there. And in this project, we want it to go to and play. And then we can choose where we want to tell it to go. Do we want to tell it to go to a certain frame number or a frame label? Or we can tell it to go to the next frame or to the previous frame. So for this one, instead of frame number, we're just going to say next frame, because we want it to go to the next frame and it's going to automatically start playing. So let's see how this works. It's just going to sit there until the user clicks a button. Uh-oh. And it looks like we have a problem. So let's go ahead and try the delete this, click on our button, global functions, timeline control, go to, and we'll choose next frame. See, there's something wrong with that. So we're going to delete the whole thing, and we're just going to go with the go to, timeline control, and go to. We want it to go to and play frame number 2. So let's go ahead and make sure that one works. So we'll click it. Okay. So from here, our stop actions are working and now our button is working. So we need to go back to our replay button and add actions there. So for this replay button, we don't necessarily want to go back to frame 1, because then we're going to have that start button and they're going to have to press another button. And that's just kind of irritating. So with the replay button, we're going to also have it jump to frame 2. Timeline control, go to, frame number 2. That way they don't have to worry about hitting the start button. So when they hit replay now, it's going to take them all the way back to frame 2 and it's going to play it. Well, let's make sure we did go to and play and not go to and stop. So I'll go ahead and do this. and it says go to and play frame number 2 and I'll test it out later and it should work just fine.